guys, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. So today I'm going to show you how I learned every note across the neck, and with that, how I learned to solo using a more along the neck approach. And all that you'll have to do is use the study method that I'm going to cover in this video for around 5 weeks. Now, watching this lesson will be excellent for anyone who is trying to play scales and play solos more along the lateral span of the fingerboard. And it's often a complex problem to try and fix for students, because pretty much all the scale layouts that we see in books and on the internet, they all show scales in position, you know, perform more vertically. So if you've ever wanted to break free of being an in position guitar player, then this will be the lesson for you. Our first step covers analyzing how one scale from one key can be laid out on one string. And the way this scale will look on the neck horizontally will help us in this method's next step, which will be all about isolating one scale segment and then splitting the string sets into a lower register. And then eventually you can do the upper register on your own. Now, I'd recommend spending about a week and a half on this topic to learn it thoroughly. We're going to focus on the C major scale for this lesson. So on the third guitar string, we're going to line up the notes for C major. From the C root at 5th fret, we'll drop in behind and get a B, an A, and an open 3rd string G. And then ahead from the 5th fret C there, we're going to head over to D, E, F, and G. So that'll be our C major scale lined up just on the third guitar string there. Another thing that we need to understand, though, is the order of harmony for this key. That means, what are the chords in the key of C major? Well, they are C major, D minor, E minor, F major, G major, A minor, and B diminished. If you don't understand harmony like this, grab yourself a copy of my Handouts Collection ebook. It goes through this information in detail with exercises. Now, the next thing I want to cover is we're going to isolate the low register of the neck. So you first of all want to understand where your notes of the C major scale are. They're going to be found at 5, 4, 2, and then ahead here from 5 up to 7. So those are the notes that we're organizing for our exercise. And then the next thing that we would do is just choose a chord. I'm going to choose F chord out of the key. And then what we just do is walk down through some notes on the third string. We'll go 7, 5, and 4 like that. And then we'll just head over to 4th string. We'll grab a 7 and a 5 and then end up on 5th string 8th fret, because that's an F. And now we've connected with that chord. Can hear the harmony of it. So it's a very easy exercise. We're going to do this with all the positions in this area, and once we get it down, you're going to really get to know your neck quite well. Coming up next, we're going to work out the remainder of the position that we started, and then we're going to learn an along the neck melody that's composed using the low register. But before we get into that, I want to take just 60 seconds to tell you about a special promotion that's related to some of the most popular lessons I use right here in my studio with my students. It's my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here, and if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale, and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5, or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. Once you understand that every note of the scale not only operates along one string and follows the key's harmony, but also that we can use each chord of the key's harmony as a way to track melody lines both vertically and horizontally. See, this works so great because when we follow chord tones, we get a chance to understand how every position can relate to the chord of the key. So coming up, I said that I have a melody which applies the scale tones with this method, but just before we jump into learning that melody, I want to spend a few minutes to expand on this with three more shapes in this low register. So let's start by doing a quick review of this low register portion of the C major scale that we're focusing on. Remember, the C root is on 3rd string 5th fret. There's a D ahead of it, and then there's a B and an A. And if you want to, there's also an open 3rd string G, but we're not really going to utilize that in our exercises. And if you'll recall, remember we did F. So now what we're going to do next is move from the F drop down in harmony to E. E minor is the next chord down from F, so we would just run the scale from that point. And then the next chord after that is D, so we would just run through into the D. And then we'd finish off running into the C note. So you can tell, excellent exercise to do. As you go through it, remember to say the names of the notes out loud because it's super important. In the handout that I have for the Patreon students, what you're gonna be able to do is see all the notes on the staff so you'll be able to run them down. You know, like for instance, if we went back to the E minor, so our notes that we're running through there are gonna be C, B, A, G, F, E. If we go to the D minor, it's just gonna be B, A, G, F, E, D, D. Just like that. So it's a great exercise. All we're doing is just isolating a few notes. In this case, it's going between 3rd string to the 5th string. But, you know, at home, as you get more and more involved with this, of course, you're going to want to expand. We're going in a descending fashion here into the lower strings. But, of course, later you'd want to work ascending as well. It's just a fantastic exercise for not only getting your harmony down, but also getting your notes down on the neck as well. Now that you understand this method of taking one scale and plotting it out across one guitar string with a focus on learning notes in a region that's all based upon the chord harmony of the key, we can now take this idea and learn how this works when we construct melody lines. And in the next example, I've composed a simple melody in the low register that we've been focused on. And when doing this work at home, give yourself at least a week to compose your melodic ideas and to create the melodic exercises. All right, so the first thing that I want to do is play this melody for you with the backing track. So if you're a Patreon member, you will get this jam loop, and there's going to be another jam loop as part of the Patreon download if you are a Patreon member, because we're going to go over another melody in the Patreon video. So anyway, here is this melody. I'm going to play it, and then I'll teach it to you. It goes like this. All right, so what's happening there is we're starting off into a C major chord, and we're using the 5th frets of 3rd and 4th strings, and then we're going over into a 7th fret 5th string, back to the 5th fret 4th string. And then what we're going to do is play on the 7th fret of 4th string, and then some faster notes on 5th string with 5th fret and 7th fret as a hammer-on, coming around into the 5th fret again on 4th string. And all of that is really targeting quite heavily, as you can tell, into the 5th fret G on the 4th string. So that G note is the perfect 5th of that C chord, so that's why it sounds so good. Now, when we go over to the next chord in the progression, which is an F, we're going to take the A note on 2nd string 3rd fret, walk from an F to a G back to the A. And the reason the A is getting kind of pointed at there is because the A is the major third of the F chord, so it's another really strong note. When we finally finish things off in that second measure with the E minor chord's appearance, what we're going to do is shoot over to the E on the 7th fret of 5th string, and then we're going to have a 5th fret G, and then a hammer-on that goes real quick from the 5th fret to 7th fret, and then back to that fifth fret, which is sort of anticipating the arrival of that C chord again, because the fifth fret of the third string, as you probably have come to know, is a C note. And this is really the point of doing this kind of work, is the more that you focus on short spans of notes that happen, in this case, we're doing it off the third guitar string for a C major scale, and the more that you do this, the more you start to recognize what your notes are in certain areas. And if you do know a little bit of your music theory, at least enough to understand chord tone targeting, which again is something that you really should understand. I talk about it in the Handouts Collection ebook. It's a, you know, important element of being able to play, because every chord that you, you know, have in a song, it has sweet spot notes, you know, those really good tones that you want to point into. And they're just the chord tones, they're the notes of the chord. If you learn how to do that, you're going to be able to have melodies that tighten up right into the sound of each chord. And it's a very powerful skill to have as a musician. So there you have it. Those are all of the breakdowns of the notes and how they function through this chord progression. Like I said, it's a simple two-bar chord progression, but I will have it as a jam track for my Patreon members. Well, guys, there is a bonus Patreon video for this lesson, and in it, I'm going to take this approach up to the higher fretboard region on the neck. We'll learn a new group of lateral scale layouts, and we'll learn a new melody that takes on the entire span of the whole fretboard. Also, keep in mind that if you're a Patreon member, you always get a detailed PDF handout of the whole lesson, along with jam tracks. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month member today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and a thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. There's a full beginners program there, intermediate, advanced. There's tons of electives that you can take, like acoustic guitar, guitar soloing, guitar technique, ear training, music reading. There's tons of stuff, and it's all well organized, well thought out, and I've used it for just literally years and years. I started teaching this course in 1996, so there's a good track record behind it. Plus, you're also going to want to make sure you're seeing these guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.